We'll give you a quick tour of the AMS 2020 GUI. The first part will show you AMS input. Next, I will show you how to visualize results. And finally, I will show some MD features. So the first part is showing AMS input. To start AMS input, use the new input command from the SCM menu. In the window that pops up, on the left you will have an area that is for building your molecule. And on the right there's an area where you can set all the different input options. And let's have a close look at that. Here, the engine that is currently used is shown, that is ADF. You could also select the Bent engine or DFTB, force field, machine learning potential, MOPAC, VXFF, conformance hybrid, etc. The force field engine is new. It replaces the old UFF and MM engines. The machine learning potential is completely new. And ReaxFF replaces the old ReaxAMS engine. So it's the AMS implementation of ReaxFF. Now, for AMS, there's in the input always a section that deals with the AMS options, and there's another section that deals with engine-specific options. If we go to the different input option panels, you see here we have a menu with all kinds of AMS input options, and then at the end there's a list of ADF input options. Also for the properties menu, here first we have a set of AMS input options, and here we have a whole list of ADF properties. And in this menu, also first a set of AMS options, then a set of ADF options. And the same for all the other engines. So the AMS options, they are available and they are identical for all engines, no matter which one of these you select. If you go to the main panel, or we already are at the main panel, that's actually a mix of AMS options and engine options. They are the most important things that you will have to set. So the first thing is the task, typically the AMS task. And this menu, again, first the AMS options and at the end some ADF specific options. So for example, here we select a geometry optimization. Then you can select whether or not to perform a frequency calculation after the geometry has converged. You can set the charge of your system. These are all AMS options. Then there's a lot of ADF options. For example, you can select which functional to use. For example, let's use the PBE functional. And you can select, for example, the basis set. Let's, in this case, select TZ2P. And of course, we need a molecule to run the calculation for. In this case, let's search for ibuprofen. And now let's have a look at what the run script looks like. You see that ADF is no longer executed, but it's AMS that's being executed. We selected the geometry optimization task. Next follows the AMS input, which is the definition of your system. So the atomic coordinates and bonds. And then follows the engine input, and in this case it only needs the basis set that we are going to use and the XC functional that we are going to use. And as you see, the input is completely different from the old style ADF input, but it is rather readable. A nice feature that is also new is has to do with the basis set. I selected here the TZ2P basis set. If you go to the basis panel, you can actually see what basis functions are being used. So for carbon, it's the ADF SORA TZ2P C with 1S core basis file, etc. And if you make a change, for example, you select to use no core, this will be updated automatically. Another change in AMS input is the atom details panel. It is it also lives in the atoms menu, but it's much more accessible right here. And it is used to set different properties, for example, the mass of atoms. If you select one of the hydrogens, you can just edit this field, and now, oops, that's a little bit heavy for hydrogen. So now we have a hydrogen with a mass of 2. And you can also change the color of atoms, for example, make this particular hydrogen orange. So now you see that the hydrogen is orange and this one is the heavy hydrogen. Obviously the color doesn't matter for amps, it's also not passed to amps, but the mass will be. And in different modules you can also do things like set the force field type or force field charge, etc. Finally, the export, there are some export options that I want to show. If you select part, just copy and then paste, you see that part is copied as XYZ. If you have a crystal, for example, let's search for diamond. Here we have the crystal. There are some nice features in the lattice vector panel. For example, you can now also set the lattice vectors by length and angle. So let's make one. The vector is much larger, but you also can change the angle if you wish. So in this case, also when you select and copy and now paste, it will be pasted in XYZ format, but also the lattice vectors will be pasted. And whatever is being, you can also copy and paste this back into EMS input. Finally, some other ways to export data. If you go to the export coordinates menu, you can export XYZ, MOL, SDF, SIF, PGF. And what is new, there's now also an export via ASE, so all the export formats that are supported by AXE can be used. And that concludes what I wanted to show you about AMS input. How to visualize results. That's quite easy, so let's just do it. We start out by setting up a small calculation. For example, a geometry optimization of hexane. Okay, geometry optimization, let's use a triple zeta p basis set and run it. And while it's running, you see here the progress in AMS jobs. You can also click on there and then you can see the progress in the log file. What is much nicer is following the progress with AMS Movie. And AMS Movie shows you the AMS.rkf file, not the log file, which means that it actually shows you the final result file while it's being updated. And you can see that it's updating in real time. Every time information about a new iteration is available, the graph is updating. This is the part of the video that you take your coffee. Okay, and the calculation is done. We don't need to use these results as we are not going to use those results. AMS Movie, you can actually also select part of your molecule, copy and paste, just like in ADF or AMS input. This feature has been added to all modules that show the molecule. So you already have seen how to visualize the progress of the optimization using Amps Movie. Next, let's try Amps View. Amps View opens the adf.rkf file. That's the file that contains all the orbital information. So Amps View can use it to display orbitals. A nice other new feature of Amps View I will show you is that if you have some atom information like charges that are being displayed, these are the Hirschfeld charges, you can make a selection and then at the bottom you can see the sum of the selected charges. So this is almost zero. If I would select only the hydrogen atoms, you can see that it is a much larger positive charge. And so you can easily see how much charge is in a particular part of your molecule. So now I selected half, and no surprise, the charge is almost zero. All the modules work this way, so you can also, you can also in this case select a couple of atoms, copy and paste, you get ID, it works in all modules. So let's now try any levels. You see it just works, just like the previous version. And the point is that it automatically opens the correct file, which in this case is the adf.rkf file. You can also use the KF browser. That is that shows you kind of the raw information on the binary KF files. In this case, it starts with the amps.rkf file. So there you can see your calculation details, the user input, etc. For ADF, the ADF results are on the adf.rkf file. So you have to go to the adf.rkf related file. And please note there's a very convenient command T shortcut. So just use that and then you get all the ADF results. And the most results are, for example, the bond energy. You can immediately see here. And you can copy paste it to wherever you like. Next, some new MD features. And as a demonstration, let's make a very, very simple system. Just two ethane molecules. And let's use a force field, UFF force field for this. And what I'm going to show you in this case is that you can actually use regions in amps. So we put this molecule into one region with the command G shortcut. Where is it here? New region from selected atoms. We select a molecular dynamics calculation. 10,000 steps, the initial velocities and with an initial temperature of 20K, so it's pretty cold. Now we make a thermostat. Beer is a thermostat with a temperature of 2000K. But we apply it only to the atoms in region 1. So the everything will be initialized with 20K, except for this molecule, it will be heated by a thermostat with 2000 Kelvin. Now, if we run this, and look at the movie, you see that one molecule is going really slowly, and the other one is running like crazy. So if we see this again, so you can clearly see that the thermostat applies only to one molecule and not to both. In the input, you can see that this is actually really done via the regions. The previous version of ADF inputs actually converted regions to atom numbers. In this case, that's no longer needed because AMPS just knows regions. So for the thermostat, the region is specified and the region information is passed to the input by specifying the region in the system information. The next thing to show is a nice feature in the builder. So imagine that we are going to need a box filled with water. So we use the builder, edit, builder. And let's say we have a box of 15 angstrom in all directions. And we fill it with 100 water molecules. Distance 1.5 angstrom from each other, at least. You see that just works as it was before. However, if you show the repeated copies of this cell, you see there's empty space between the images. And the reason is that the builder that we use, the PECMO program, does not handle periodic boundary conditions. So we need some empty space to avoid collision between atoms. And as a trick around this empty spaces, you can now perform this packing with multiple cycles. It does exactly the same as you just saw, but every time it shifts the unit cell around a little bit. So let's do this now in 7 cycles, and if we now generate molecules, you see that the result is much more homogeneous. It's not perfect, but it's much improved. This does not work very well if you have big molecules, because these big molecules, they will be removed if they lie on the boundary. So the default is still just to use one cycle. Finally, I would like to show some analysis tools that we now have for MD. And for that, I will use a calculation that I already did. And calculation on water. Now we have the RDF tool, the radial distribution function, and you can use it to very easily calculate and show radial distribution functions. For example, the oxygen distances, so here you see the first shell and then the next and so on. Or you could use, for example, the distance of hydrogen to other hydrogens. Where you get a very big peak at the position of the hydrogens inside one molecule, of course. You can also specify specific atoms. So, for example, if you select that oxygen, you will now have the distance from that oxygen to all other hydrogen atoms, etc. It's up to the user what they want to show. Another analysis tool is the autocorrelation function. For example, for the dipole moment, in this case generated from the charges. So if you calculate it, you get the requested autocorrelation function, and you get the Fourier transform of that function. You can also select the velocity autocorrelation function, or you can calculate the diffusion coefficient. You can calculate it from the velocity autocorrelation function. You can do it automatically this way. And you see now you get the autocorrelation function and the dipole moment, the diffusion moment. The diffusion constant is being displayed right here. That concludes the analysis options in AlmsMovie that we added. One minor detail that I forgot to mention, or maybe not, you can select atoms also in AlmsMovie. Copy, paste. It works everywhere.